Hello everyone, myself Dr. Jyoti Mandala. Welcome you all to the video lecture series on object-oriented programming through Java. We are learning the inheritance concept, where as part of inheritance we have learned about different types of inheritance. We learned about what actually an inheritance is, and we learned three types of inheritance: single inheritance, multi-level inheritance and hierarchical inheritance. The fourth type of inheritance, which is multiple inheritance, we are going to learn about at the time of learning interface concept. Now, today's class we will be learning about a new keyword which is called as a super keyword. Whereas coming to keywords concept, we have already learned about static keyword and this keyword. So this super keyword will work with inheritance concept. So let us learn about what actually this super keyword is and how it will be useful in our inheritance concept. Normally, super keyword, whenever we are going to use it, is used to access the superclass members. Like whenever you are using this super keyword in a subclass, it will be used to access the superclass members only. Superclass members in the sense, if you are going to use the variables or constructors or methods of the superclass, then in the subclass we can access the superclass members simply by writing super. Now, how to use that one? So we can be using this super in three ways. The first two ways will be using the constructor, where we already learned in detail about the constructor. Constructors are of two types: parameterless constructors and parameterized constructor. So if you want to use a super keyword with parameterless constructor, we are going to use this method this way. And if you are going to call, or if you going to access the superclass parameterized constructor, then we are going to use this one. In detail we are going to learn in this lecture in detail about how we are going to use these two. And the third way is to access the superclass members of variables and methods. Then that can be done by using super keyword with a dot operator. About this third way of using or accessing the super superclass instance variables or methods using super keyword, we will be learning in the next lecture. So in today's lecture, we will be confining ourselves to call the superclass constructor only using the super keyword. Okay, so let us start our today's class now. So whenever a subclass want to create an object, then a superclass constructor will be automatically called first. Now when it is called, it will be called automatically if it is a parameterless constructor. Then the Java runtime will automatically call the superclass unparameterized constructor automatically. Okay, whenever the subclass object is created. But if you have a parameterized constructor in the superclass, then it is the responsibility of user to write down this statement. So how we need to do these tasks, I'll explain you with simple examples. Okay, so I am telling you once again, call it to the superclass constructor whenever you are doing. It should be a first statement in the subclass constructor. Like we can have any statement in the constructor, but if you are talking about calling the superclass constructor, then that should be your first statement in your subclass constructor. So let us see the first way of calling the unparameterized constructor. I'll take one example and let me explain through an example. So I'll take one class A, and this is a constructor of that. We all know how to write down the constructor. Always the constructor name should be equal to the class name. All these things in detail about the constructor we have already learned. So here I'm considering a unparameterized constructor. So that means there are no parameters in my constructor. And in this constructor I have only one statement, where I am having one output statement, where it is displaying this is constructor of class A. Okay, and this is the end of your class A, and I am taking class B, which is extending this class A, and this class B having its own constructor. Now if you see in this constructor, if you are writing like this, and in this constructor we are having one output statement where it is writing like this is the constructor of class B, and this is the end of this class B. But if you can see here, super, I have written with parenthesis, empty parenthesis. Whenever you are writing like this, this is an optional thing. Even if you write or if you don't write, it will automatically call whenever an object of this class B is created in your main method. See here, I have created an object called B1. Whenever an object is created, then the B constructor will be called. It will come here, then Whenever you are writing like this parameterless constructor, then the Java virtual machine will automatically call move its control to its superclass constructor. Even if you write the super keyword like this, or if you even if you don't write like this, it is an optional statement. It will go here and it will execute the parameterless unparameterized constructor of the superclass. That means this statement in our example, it will display this output, and it will, after executing this one, it will come back to here, and whatever statements you have back next to this one, that will be executed. So you need to understand here, in an unparameterized constructor, the superclass unparameterized constructor will be called automatically by the Java virtual machine, even if you don't write the super also. But if you want to write super, then that should be the first statement of your constructor, that within the constructor, right? So whenever you execute this program, this will be the output, this will be the expected output. Now the same program can be written in the other way, where you can omit this statement. I'll show you that one also. I have taken the class unparameterized constructor, class B has been taken, observe here, super keyword has not been used, and I am creating the object of this B. Now if you are trying to execute this program, observe here, B constructor will be called, and whenever B constructor is called, the Java virtual machine will automatically call the unparameterized constructor, even if there is no super keyword also. But if you want to put the super keyword, you need to put that one as a first statement here. That is what we learned in the previous slide. Now the control will come here, this statement will be displayed. Now control will come back here, and this statement will be displayed, it will come back here, and this is the end of your program. So whenever you run this program and try to check the output, you will be getting this output. Now what we'll do is, let us run this program. So for that, what we need to do is, we need to open a notepad, okay, and then let us create one class A. I'm taking the same example. So in that, I'm taking one constructor. You all know how to write down the constructor, and here I'm trying to write down one output statement, out dot. Let us check whether it is working properly or not. Okay, so this is the constructor what I am writing in A, and I am taking one class B, and it has to extends A. So now class B is extending A. Now I am writing the constructor. So this is the constructor of B, and the same thing I want to write. Okay, so I will be writing, and in B, are you understanding all of you? So I am writing constructor B, and observe here, I have not written any super statement. Now what I want to do is, I want to write one class, super test. Let us consider a class name, and then in here I need to write main method. Okay, so in this I need to create an object of B. So B, let us call the object is B, small b, new B. So whenever an object is created, the constructor will be automatically called. You all know about this. The constructor will be called at the time of object creation. Now we need to save this program first. So the program name should be this class name. So let me save this one first. So you all know this procedure, how to save the things and all. Okay, here I need to tell you, if you put this entire name s test dot test in double quotes, no need to change this save as type. But if you are not putting in the double quotes, you need to change this one as all files. Okay, so let us save this one, and now we need to run this program. To run this program, what actually you need to do is, you need to go to the command prompt, or else what can you do is, you can open this folder where your programs have been stored, and in the address bar click here and simply type cmd. Then what happens, it will display the command prompt. Are you understanding? It will go to the directly to the command prompt, or else up to our last video, how we have learned is, we have opened the command prompt, and it will be opening the default path, and there we need to move to the command, we need to move to the path by writing d colon enter button, all these things. But directly if you want to move, you can move like this. Okay, are you clear? Okay, now what we need to do now is, let us run this program. So what is our program now? Java C, yes, test dot java, right? I think I have saved it wrong way. So let me check. let me save this, save as this. See, I have saved it as est_test.test. Let me rename it. Okay, job. Got it, all of you? What is the mistake I have done? Save. Now let us clear this screen and let us run. Now if any errors are there, that will be displayed. If no errors are there, yes, in our program no errors are there. Now here what you need to understand is, even if you don't write any super keyboard here, even though you don't write that one, if you try to run your program, okay, so it will be calling this constructor automatically. So that's why we got an output of in class A. Observe here, we got in class in A and in B next. That means you need to understand the flow here. Even though no super is written, whenever an object of a subclass is created, then the super class unparameterized constructor will be automatically called by the Java virtual machine. If you want, you can add a statement called super also, there is no problem. But if you want to add, you need to make a note here. What you need to do, you need to write that one as the first statement. Okay, all of you, now let us run this program. Let us check this. Okay, now you can check, if you have added the super also, there is no problem. But if this super is shifted to here, you will be getting an error. So this is how the program will be run for unparameterized constructor. That is your first option. Now let us see the second option. This is the thing where here I want to tell, the constructor, superclass constructor, has made a private. But at that time, if you are trying to access this, that one, then it will throw an error. Why? Because private is nothing but we are not giving access to others to access this thing. So if it is made as a private, you have no right to access that one. In such a case, you will be getting an error like A has a private access in A. So a subclass can't use that one. Okay, to avoid this one, you should not do like this. You should not write two constructors, one with private and one with the without private. If you are trying to do like this, then also you will be getting an error saying like A is already defined and A has been defined as a private. Then you should not overload this one like this. Got it? So this is about how a superclass can be calling an unparameterized constructor. But the second way, where if you have a parameterized constructor, then how the super will work. Now if you see here, the same example I have modified, where I have taken one parameter here. Parameter means we need to pass one argument into this constructor. So in such a case, if a subclass, in a subclass, it is, if you are not using any super keyword, in this case if you see here, B is extending the class A and B constructor is not calling the A constructor. It has been written, it is writing its own statements, and we have created one object. In such a case, it will be showing an error saying like cannot find a symbol of constructor A and all. Why? Because remember, whenever a subclass constructor you are writing, you need to call a superclass parameterized constructor forcefully. You need to do that one. It is the responsibility of the user to avoid this error. Where I'll show you how can we do that one. We need to add a statement called super, and we need to pass one argument. Why? Because this is a parameterized constructor. Super, we are saying it is nothing but we want to call the superclass constructor. What is our superclass? A is our superclass, and A constructor we want to call. Which type of constructor we are passing? One parameter. It is nothing but we want to call one parameter constructor. If you have one more constructor A with two parameters, if you pass two parameters, that constructor will be called. Both are considered under the category of parameterized constructor only. So you need to understand here, whenever a subclass constructor is executing, we need to add a super keyword where the parameter has to be passed there, and it is the responsibility where we need to add this statement to call the super class parameterized constructor. It is must. So the earlier program, whatever we have learned, we have seen the error that can be rectified simply by adding this statement where we will be getting this output. Are you understanding? So it's super A2, you will go, it will go here, these statements will be executed, it will come back and these statements will be executed. Understood? So let us check this program. So to make it more clear, what I'll do is let me change the same program. What I have done is let me write one parameter here. What I'll do is int a. Okay, so what I'll do, I will display that a value here. Simply I'm writing, passing one parameter to a. Okay, and now in b, what I will be doing, in I need to take two variables. One variable is to pass as a parameter to super constructor and one variable to display here. Okay, just so now what happens whenever you create any object, here we need to pass two variables. What are the two variables? 10 and 20 I am passing. Then what happens, 10 will be copied to A and 20 will be copied to B. Now what I want to do, A, whatever value is there, that I want to pass to this parameter. So we need to pass call super A, and I want to display B value here, B. Okay, and then I will be display B value. Very simple. But so what we have done here, whenever you are trying to call a superclass parameterized constructor, you can do that one, to call that superclass constructor by adding a super and write down the parameters, that many number of parameters, whichever constructor you want to call, whichever parameterized constructor you want to call. So let us save this program and let us go back to our command prompt and let me compile this program. Okay, so we have got no errors and let me run this program. You can check here, we got, let me tell you the explanation, 10, 20, A value is 10, B value is 20, super 10 will be passed here, A value will be 10 now, so A 10 will be displayed. So we got A 10. So after executing this one, it will come back here, system.out.println, B, what is the value of B? 20, so B 20 is displayed. Got it? Suppose if you remove this one, if you remove this one, let us check whether it is working or not. Now how it will be running, so you can see here there is an error. Why? Because I am telling you, whenever we are taking any parameterized constructor in a super class, we need to have a super keyword, we need to have this statement, and that statement should be the first statement in our subclass constructor. Okay, so to avoid this one, we need to remove this one and we need to save this one back and we need to run, compile this program once again, and that means we have solved our problem. Got it? So this is how a super class, which is whenever it is having a parameterized constructor, can be called by using your super keyword. Okay, so these are the two ways how a super keyword can be used to call your super class constructor. It can be a parameterized constructor or it can be a parameterless constructor. I hope you all are clear with this concept. In the next lecture, we'll see about the third way of using super keyword, where that keyword can be used to call your variables and methods. Okay, so let us all meet in our next lecture. Until then, thank you all of you.